Welcome to the third quarter earnings presentation of KLCCP Staple Group for the period ended 30 September 2020. We hope that you and your family are keeping safe and healthy during this challenging time. Early this year, our Prime Minister announced a movement control order for Malaysia as a preventive measure in response to the COVID-19 pandemic in the country. Since then, Malaysia has been through several phases of movement control orders with all the strict SOPs recommended by the World Health Organization to effectively contain the COVID-19 outbreak. No doubt, this global pandemic has affected all sectors in the economy, including our business operations. The ongoing pandemic and the various phases of lockdown has impacted the nine-month performance for the period ended 30 September 2020, with year-on-year revenue declining 11.7% to RM 934.4 million and profit before tax to RM 591.6 million. This is mainly contributed by the rental assistance granted to the retail tenants and cancellation of room bookings and events, coupled with international border closures affecting the hotel segment. The group, however, continued to prioritize cost containment measures, including rationalizing operating and capital expenditures to optimize cash flows and continue to step up efforts to restore stakeholder trust. For the third quarter financial year 2020, the group saw its revenue and profit before tax decline by 11.6% and 16.9% respectively compared to the third quarter financial year 2019 due to challenging operating environment. However, in comparison to the preceding quarter, KLCCP Staple Group posted a revenue of RM 312.6 million and profit before tax of RM 195.5 million, an increase of 17% and 19.3% respectively, contributed by a steady recovery from the retail and hotel segments. On the segmental revenue, all segments contributed to positive increase in revenue for third quarter financial year 2020 compared to the second quarter financial year 2020. The office segment remained the major contributor to KLCCP Staple Group's revenue, with a marginal increase in revenue, while the retail segment saw a 40.4% increase in revenue, benefiting from the pickup in footfall and tenant sales. Hotel segment gained traction from staycation demand and improved F&B performance, resulting in an increase of more than 100% in revenue. The management services segment, which continues to complement the property portfolio, also saw an improved performance, growing 16.6% in revenue. Despite the headwinds and the challenges faced, the group delivered stable returns to its holders of Staple Security with a distribution of 750 cent per Staple Security for the quarter, bringing the total dividend distribution for the cumulative 9 months for financial year 2020 to 23.30 cents. The group remains disciplined and prudent in managing its capital structure, with our bank facilities intact for the next refinancing, which is due in April 2021. Our cost of debt remained at 4.5%, with 85% of total borrowings on fixed rate, while total gearing ratio remains well below the industry benchmark, providing solid foundation to withstand near-term uncertainties. The office segment, comprising Petronas Twin Towers, Menara 3 Petronas, Menara Daya Bumi and Menara ExxonMobil, continue to be the income generator to the group, underpinned by the long-term lease profile and full occupancy at all the office towers. The segment's revenue remained stable, with marginal increase in profit before tax arising from lower operating expenditure. In respect to the asset enhancement initiative, the 10-meter new pedestrian bridge connecting Menara Daya Bumi to Central Market was completed in October 2020. This will enhance the connectivity between Menara Daya Bumi and Central Market while experiencing the River of Life initiatives, which is one of the Malaysia's economic transformation program in the Greater Kuala Lumpur. The retail segment, represented by Suria KLCC and Retail Podium of Menara 3 Petronas, saw its 9 months performance impacted by the closure of stores during MCO, low consumer sentiment coupled with rental assistance provided to tenants. The segment recorded a 17.3% and 22% year-on-year decline in revenue and profit before tax respectively, mainly due to the rental assistance granted to tenants coupled with lower internal digital advertising income. following the implementation of the Recovery Movement Control Order and the reopening of businesses, Suria KLCC saw a gradual recovery in footfall and tenant sales prior to the spike in COVID-19 cases sometime in mid-September 2020. Despite the lingering effect of the COVID-19, Suria KLCC stayed true to its tagline of always something new, with 6 new tenants coming on board during the quarter, which included 4 first-to-market tenants who made their first presence in the country: Babe and its Babe Cafe, the first one of its kind in the world; A Lunch and Sony; Baluti; and Dragon Eye with its first halal restaurant. Though the recovery of the retail segment is expected to be further dampened with the reimposition of the CMCO, Suria KLCC will continue its effort in driving traffic and sales through experiential, reward-driven and trade campaigns, as well as developing strategic partnerships and collaboration with tenants. The hotel segment performance continues to be adversely affected, resulting in Mandarin Oriental Kuala Lumpur recording a year-on-year decline in revenue of 66.3%, which led to a loss of RM 45.6 million. Mandarin Oriental Kuala Lumpur's sale, however, peaked in third quarter 2020, mainly contributed by higher F&B and banqueting demand, good traction from the staycation promotions, and continuous activation of digital marketing initiatives. Despite the resurgence of the COVID-19 cases recently and uncertainty in borders reopening, MOKL Hotel will continue its effort to capture domestic business by stepping up promotional offerings with enticing packages to attract corporate and group demands. Our management services segment continues to offer reliable professional services as solutions partner, adopting best emerging technology. This segment recorded a year-on-year increase in revenue of 23.7%, mainly due to the new business approach in the facility management services. However, profit before tax was impacted due to the lower car park income. To elevate the standard of car parking and deliver an exceptional level of parking experience for our customers, KLCC Parking Management is currently working towards the completion of the premium parking and transitioning all our car parks towards fully cashless. Recently, KLCC Urus Hartas and Rian Berhad and KLCC Parking Management were both recognized at the internationally renowned Royal Society for the Prevention of Accidents, Health and Safety Awards with a Gold and Silver Award respectively for their practices and achievements in health and safety excellence. As the COVID-19 crisis continues to unfold around the globe, undoubtedly there will be challenges in the coming months. But we at KLCCP Staple Group continue to focus with stakeholder emphasis to position our business continuity. We personalize tenant experience and continue to provide a safe working environment, adhering to the SOPs at all our office buildings. We encourage our retail tenants to continue to reach out to shoppers via social media platforms, drive marketing campaigns to boost traffic and sales, and reinforce our presence and visibility in the hospitality industry. Though the impact of the pandemic is unavoidable, we will continue to focus on responding to the needs of the organization, mitigating the adverse market conditions, and transforming our strategies towards driving recovery. Thank you.